California has a new modern home for NFL football, and it is this place, wondrous SoFi Stadium here in Inglewood.
Straight ahead, we punch the second of two tickets to the AFC title game, and we've got a great one in store between the Tennessee Titans and the Los Angeles Chargers. For a berth in the AFC Championship game, off we go in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs.
And this is going to be returned from middle of the end zone.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he'll power his way forward for about 4 yards there on the first down carry.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes, or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six.
The counter, it's Henry,
and they'll get to him quickly here as he'll get a yard, just a yard to the 22. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Opening drive as they're up against a third and five.
Now Willis.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
And it's fielded at the 34.
On that punt, we've got a man shaken up. More from L.A. in a moment. Herbert and the Chargers now with a first and 10
at the 40. They started on the ground with Eckler. And they get to him after a gain of six to the 46.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
The last run got six, now second and four.
Once more, here's Eckler. And he's got some. And oh, he coughed it up. It's picked up by the Titans. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Do you remember in preseason we were going to the different training camps and visiting teams, and we always would see the running backs working out and going through those.
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Running on first down, Eckler. Oh, an absolutely filthy juke. He's got some space now. You were telling me this yesterday. That's exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get left.
fantastic play, not only to pick that off, but he had to run a long way, Charles, in the other direction to hit pay dirt. He did it, and they got the first lead.
And that certainly changes the early tone of this game, doesn't it, partner? One moment, they were going to be in early control. Now they just have a few moments to clear their heads and get back out there against an electrified defense.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Taylor now from the end zone. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. So holding will scratch off some of that return.
And I know fans get frustrated when they see penalties of this sort on kick returns, but it is difficult to do it right against these moving targets at full speed. Hard to do.
On first and 10, Herbert. Pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring him down. Danico Autry collapses the pocket and drops him for a loss of three. So after the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable second and 13. Here's Herbert. They'll find Everett there, complete. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it's third and 4 now. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Third down, here's Eckler. And I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it fourth and inches. On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. And a 7-yard return following a punt of 45 yards. And it'll be Titan football. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10. Now left side on the swing pass. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. They went 3 and out on their first drive. Things already looking better here, first and 10.
Let's go now.
Henry up the middle. Taking it right down Broadway. Touchdown, Titans. They talked about stringing together some explosive plays here in the playoffs. That was a pretty explosive play.
It certainly was. And if you're going to win on the road, it certainly helps to have big playability in your hip pocket, doesn't it?
Extra point up and good by Bullock. And that'll make the score 14 to zip. Chargers nothing. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. On the return, it's Taylor from his end zone. And he returns this to the 22. On the return, the Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. They're forced to play catch-up early in this division round game as they search for a seat in the AFC Championship round. Man open, that's Calvin Ridley. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. A very solid gain of 27.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
Nifty move. And this will leave them a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and 1 yard. It's Eckler again. And that'll hurt the average. This time they're able to get him behind the line. He winds up giving a yard back there, and now it's third and two.
Well, I would have figured after the 9-yard run on the previous play, getting one more yard wouldn't have been much of a problem. But apparently it was, and now it's third down.
Third and two, Herbert. And this is caught. First catch for Keenan Allen. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Justin Herbert looking to pass. On the screen, this is Eckler. Oh, what a juke into space. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
And good yardage there on first down, because sometimes all you need to do on the screen is get one key block. That might set your man free, and that was pretty good pursuit to the football defensively, or it could have gone for more.
Throwing again on second down, Herbert. Touchdown, Chargers! Keenan Allen, a 20-yard touchdown. And the Chargers have cut it back within a score. Dustin Hopkins on now to add the extra point. And that one makes it 14-7. The touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
Ready.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. The offense running out, and they are charged up, ready to go after reaching the end zone on their last drive.
And normally I'd warn against getting complacent just because they scored the last time out, but I don't think there's any worse with this group right now. This is a hungry group, and they want to keep building off of their last drive. Now they just want the officials to hurry up and place the ball so they can snap it and get back to work.
On second down, here's Henry. And a nice pickup as this one gets him to the 10-yard line. 65 yards rushing for him now as he has been strong here in the first half of this divisional round matchup. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Nasir Adderley. And the Chargers are going to take possession of the football. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Going to get it again on second down. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up third and two. They'll try to pick up the first with Eckler. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. That'll bring up fourth. They had the 8-yard gain on first down, but unable to do much from there. Hopkins' kick is good, and they'll cut the lead back down to four now at 14-10. So the interception set him up with terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say we should have done better there.
Following the made field goal for three, Hopkins now to kick it off. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive.
As the offense comes out here, Charles, maybe perhaps a bit more of a focus on the run game for this drive after tossing an interception on the previous one.
I think that's a good way to look at it and a good way to think about it, but maybe they get to it in a little bit different way because after you throw an interception, you want to make sure you keep your quarterback's confidence high. So maybe give him a couple easy throws that he can complete and then get to the running game and try and get things settled down.
Yeah, still in the first half here, a long way to go.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 27 yards there, a first down.
And time to give some credit to the big fellows, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
A first down carry for Henry. And he'll wind up getting about six out of that, as that's going to lead us to the two-minute warning. From the 40 now on second down, Willis, right side complete, that's Woods. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. The Titans efficient passing on this drive. There's another first down.
So, Charles, you look at this offense, you think about it, you got a rookie quarterback at the helm. You're in the divisional round of the playoffs here. That head of his just has to be spinning, doesn't it?
Well, normally you'd have to say yes, but I do think that the way things went last week, how he played in the wild card win, how sensational he was, that'll stop his head from spinning. And now he's in a situation that's getting towards uncharted territory because you've got Joe Flacco, Mark Sanchez, the only two rookies to win two playoff games in 1 year. He's trying to join that company.
That's to Burks, and he's got it. Touchdown, Tennessee. 23 yards for the touchdown as his guys are able to extend their lead. Bullock good on the extra point, and that makes it a 21-10 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Charger drive about to get going. They've got to be a little shell-shocked. Down double digits at home in the playoffs. Still in the first half, they've got to turn things around quickly. On first down, it's Herbert. Finds the open man, it's Mike Williams. And he'll be out right at the 35. That's good for a first down. There's a guy who went over 1,000 yards receiving in the regular season, and now he's got his first catch of the playoffs. Possession of the football. You don't see this often, a quarterback of his caliber, two first half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You would Second and 10 now from the 29. Inside handoff, Henry. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on third and 8. Again, it's Henry. And this will not get close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the 26. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Bullock's kick is good, and the lead grows to 14 at 24-10. So they get the turnover in plus territory. The drive stalls out, but still able to get 3 out of that.
Yeah, we were able to see an offense and a defense kind of mix and match with each other, didn't we? Both of them trying to make sure that they had the upper hand and the advantage. Offense trying to get to the end zone. Defense, of course, trying to hold them to a field goal attempt. And it wasn't a guaranteed lock 3 from where they started. So, you know, the offense has to be happy to come away with those 3 points.
The Charger drive about to get going.
Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, and this is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through.
He's got a man complete, and he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line.
Now, that certainly solidifies how to attack this 2-minute drill right before the half. I don't think they were going to try and run out the clock, but now after that big play, their thoughts are certainly of trying to score and get some points before the half.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. Herbert now. Looking for Ridley on the out route. He's got him. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. They were looking to throw, holding on the big right tackle.
That's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide. You're usually going to pick up a holding call.
From the 50, here's Herbert. He's going to let it go. End zone for Allen. And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out. So obviously, they will decline the penalty there, and the result is 6 points. Hopkins with the extra point, and that cuts the lead to 24-17.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Just 11 seconds to go in the half as they have it first and 10. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4.
Here's Willis.
They'll roll him out right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Oh, that's good decision-making right there. Understood down and distance. Knew it wasn't third down, and he still had another opportunity to earn the first down. Good job throwing it away and avoiding an interception.
And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. This time they stay on the ground. And they'll get it up just short.
short of the 45 at the 44. So it's on to halftime in this AFC divisional round matchup as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports halftime report. Coach? And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn getting set for quarter number three here. Win or go home, that's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC divisional round. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Charger drive about to get going.
And Charles, that had to be an interesting locker room at halftime. This is a team that's had so much success this year. Haven't really had to deal with a lot of adversity at halftime, to be honest. But now here they are with their playoff lives on the line.
And I think when you're alluding to that interesting locker room, you're just wondering, how are they handling that bit of adversity that they're seeing right now? Because I think this is a team that has to look to lean on the veterans at this point. We know we're better than this. We've proved it all season. Let them disseminate that confidence through the locker room. But this opening drive, it'll be an important one for them to give them a little jolt of confidence moving forward.
From the 27, Herbert able to hook up with Williams here on the out route. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first.
He kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now it's Herbert. That's complete to the tight end, Everett. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Up the middle with Eckler. And he'll be taken down right around the 41-yard line. The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Out of the gun, Eckler running it. Able to slither by. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
83 yards rushing for him now as he goes over the century mark here in this divisional round matchup.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
Herbert setting up to throw on first down.
They try to set up the screen. Oh, nearly disaster. But it's incomplete. Not much chance of that working. Almost intercepted. It's second down.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But this defense gets two more stops. They can keep them out of that area.
To throw again on second down. Herbert,
he gets this out to Spiller. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
This is third and a yard. They go back to the ground now with Eckler. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. Send the slot in motion left. First down, and they stick with Eckler. Only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
Second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line. On second down, Spiller looking for space. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Isaiah Spiller, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Chargers are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. Extra point good by Hopkins. And that will tie us at 24. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Titans offense set to begin the drive. After that last touchdown we just saw, Charles, we got ourselves a brand new ball game, all tied here in the third as they have their first possession of this second half.
And Brandon, this drive is all about one word to me, and that's the word answer, because they're trying to answer the momentum the other offense picked up in tying the game, because not only if they score and they feel better about themselves, they'll retake the lead and maybe set the tone for the rest of the half, keeping them in the driver's seat.
They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it second and 6.
End result of that one, a nice 4-yard gain. So you can use that to set up your play action game, or you can come right back and continue to run the football, because as an offensive play caller, you're on schedule and feeling pretty good about your next couple of calls.
Willis now off play action. This will go to Henry out wide. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game? That's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. And in this case, he picks up the first down.
Henry running right. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. From the gun, here's Willis. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And the Chargers are going to take possession of the football. The disaster there, I mean, you saw it coming. The pressure gets knocked down, the interception.
Sometimes the best throw you make is the one you
don't make.
Exactly. Take care of the football. He'll also learn how to shrug his shoulders, take the proper slide steps to alleviate some of the pressure. But occasionally, like the one we just saw, sometimes just hold on to the football and take the hit.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. And even 100 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Once more, here's Eckler.
take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
On third down, here's Eckler. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Hopkins' kick is good, and they have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
Following the made field goal for three, Hopkins now to kick it off. This is going to be returned from the... And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. And picked up by the Chargers. And they take over already 5 yards deep into the red zone at the 15-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Running on first down, Eckler. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. No gain that time, and it leaves them with third and 11 coming up. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Eckler now between the tackles. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They'll get 11, but still a little short. Fourth down. They'll run for it with Eckler. And sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. They need to come up with something as they get this drive started. 114 yards on the ground now for Henry. He's got a first down.
I guess it's good we can't really read the mind of the defensive coordinator now, huh?
Had him pinned back there deep, give up that run. Can't be happy.
Yeah, whatever's in his mind right now, we probably couldn't say over the air.
A nice burst there as they'll get about 7 that time on the first down run. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. Operating from the 27 now. Here's second and 3. They'll run it again with Henry. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's Willis. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Give him 12.
And I believe the referee's been buzzed. Yeah, they want to take another look at this call, and it's certainly a big one here late in a tight game.
So the
folks in New York just going to wind up confirming what the official saw, as this play will stand as is. Henry will get it. He's been busy today. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Throwing, Willis. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Joey Bosa in there to drop him as that clock continues to run.
The passing game's been struggling a bit today, and that was the latest example. Haven't been getting much yardage out of it, and now on his back after the last play, he faces third and long.
Tough spot for Willis and the Titans, now facing third and long following the sack. And the Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Willis to throw. This is caught. It's Woods. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 38-yard line.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
A first down carry for Henry. And a powerful stiff arm. It frees him. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. A big chunk of yardage there, 37 yards. Probably had 60,000 thinking pass right there, including us in the booth.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That was a big call, big guts on that one. And guess what? That run, it'll pay dividends.
They'll try to run for it with Henry. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. Back at the two now, here's second and goal. Trying to punch it in with Henry. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the two-yard line. A big one coming in this divisional round playoff, third and goal. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. For the lead, here's third and goal. Enforcement's coming as they're going to stop him behind the line. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. So now Randy Bullock with an important field goal try here. This to potentially send us to overtime. Bullock's kick is good, and that will tie this game here in the final minute of play. So in the final minute, they turn it over to their kicker to get him back to even, and he does not disappoint.
Brandon, do you think the pressure ever gets to this guy? Because I sure don't. That was pretty smooth right there. But I tell you, he better not rest on his laurels, because there's a good chance they may need him again if this game goes to overtime.
The Charger drive about to get going. And Charles, obviously not much time left. I'm curious to see if there's enough for them to get into field goal range and try to win this thing.
And partner, you and I both know the safe calls to kneel and just take it into overtime. But it's also very tough to pass up a chance to win it right now as well. But remember, if you do attempt that, it's got to be a big play downfield and still leave yourself enough time to get your field goal unit out there and
this stage of the game where it pays to have speed on the perimeter, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And in the second quarter, he may very well run by him. But in this situation, I know as a defender, I'm loosening up a couple of extra steps that allowed him to run with him stride for stride.
Herbert buying time to his left, airing it out, looking for Ridley. And that is intercepted. Or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion.
Well, what a game this has been, and now it'll take overtime to decide who goes on to the AFC title game.
The Charger drive about to get going.
And CD, we get to see the debut of the brand new postseason overtime rules. Now, as everybody is learning, both teams are going to be guaranteed an offensive possession. So they might get the ball first here, but a touchdown does not right away win the game.
And we saw many marker games along the way that sparked a lot of conversation. But the Buffalo-Kansas City game in the 2022 playoffs, that really brought about this rule change. What an amazing game, a true classic. Ended in overtime without Buffalo getting a shot with the football, and the people didn't like that at all. So starting this season, if you make the playoffs, you'll get a chance to answer if the other team scores first, and that way you get a chance to keep a great game as well as your hopes alive as you chase the big prize.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. It's Eckler again, and he'll get about three here up to the 44-yard line.
It's third and four. Big play here, trying to keep this opening drive of overtime alive. First throw in overtime for Herbert. And he's got a man, Calvin Ridley. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 39. 18 yards the gain for number 18. Charles, you get into these overtime situations, that's not a bad guy to dial into.
Well, when you have to have plays, especially in a spot as you just described, we're in OT. You've got to go to the guys you can trust and you know are going to make the plays. What they say, it's not the X's and the O's, it's the Jimmies and the Joes.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play there, second down.
I would think as a play call, you want to look for some quick hitters to your tight end. Any type of a route to replace where that linebacker was, because when you saw the speed with which he reacted and stuffed that play, maybe use that speed against him in the future.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss, and now it's third down.
Well, the defense coming through there, CD, with a big-time play, and they're getting close here to getting off the field and giving their offense a chance to win this ball game.
And partner, no one's cheering louder after that play than their offensive teammates because they understand how different things would be if instead of going out and needing a touchdown to tie things up, they can run out there with a chance to win the game right there.
Williams loses the football. It's picked up by the Titans. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. And a costly, costly mistake. Coaches talk so much about ball security, and in overtime, so paramount.
Partner, do you ever wonder, maybe they talk about it too much?
Too much, yeah.
Doesn't seem like you can, but maybe by discussing it time and time again, and you know they overemphasized it here, it almost became self-fulfilling.
And any points beat them here, field goal or a touchdown now. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two. Henry up the middle, and he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
On the counter, it's Henry. And just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
Now it's second and nine. Now Willis gets his shot in overtime.
Oh, and it's intercepted.
Derwin James with a pick.